الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه الحمد لله الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى الحمد لله الذي أستعينه وأستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في أول كلامنا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في أوسط كلامنا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في آخر كلامنا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاذمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين صدق الله العظيم وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الكيس من دان نفسه وعمل لما بعد الموت والعاجز من أتبع نفسه هواها وتمنى على الله أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام رواه الترمذي رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ My respected brothers and elders in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this life one time. This life that we have, this is a one-time thing. We will not be raised up again. You know, the idolaters used to say, هَيْهَاتَ هَيْهَاتَ لِمَا تُوْعَدُونَ إِنْ هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَبْعُوثِينَ They used to say, that this is your life, enjoy this life. Enjoy your life. Whatever you want to do, you do. Whatever you like to do, you do it. Whatever you love, whether it's haram, halal, it's the command of Allah, it's not the command of Allah, do whatever you desire. In hiya illa hayatun ad-dunya. This is the life to enjoy. Namutu wa nahya. When you die, you will not wake up again. Wama nahnu bimab'uthin. You will not be resurrected. You will not be resurrected. My brothers and elders, this is ayah in Surah Waqi'ah. The idolaters, the people of Makkah, the mushrikeen used to say, أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا وَعِظَامًا أَإِنَّا لَمَبْعُوثُونَ أَوَآبَاؤُنَا الْأَوَّلُونَ You know, they actually ask a question, you know, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That أَإِذَا مِتْنَا وَكُنَّا تُرَابًا Do you think that when we die, you know, our body will decay? And it will be decomposed. It will be clay and sand. You know, inna lamabu'uthun. Do you think we will be resurrected? You know, awa aba unal awwalun. My forefather will be resurrected. My grandfather, my father. So Allah replies in Surah Waqiyah. Qul, say to them, say to these people of Makkah and the whole world. Innal awwalina wal akhirin. Indeed, the people coming from Adam alayhi salam. Wal akhirin. People coming, the last person on earth. You know, Allah is saying, لَمَجْمُعُونَ I will gather all of you. إِلَى مِيقَاتِ يَوْمٍ مَعْلُومٍ There is an appointed time. There is an appointed time that I will gather you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Quran, الْحَاقَّةِ What is reality? مَالْحَاقَّةِ Do you know what is reality? وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَالْحَاقَّةِ Do you think the life of Columbus, Ohio is reality? And then Allah, you know, when you read a book, My brothers and elders, when you read a book, there is a foreword. It's called preface. You know, it doesn't talk about the summary or the topic of the subject, but it just talks about that the author and talks about what the summary is, what he wants to talk about. So likewise, Allah mentions here, كَذَّبَتْ ثَمُودُ وَعَادٌ بِالْقَارِعَةِ فَأَمَّا ثَمُودُ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِالطَّاغِيَةِ وَأَمَّا عَادٌ فَأُهْلِكُوا بِرِيحٍ صَرْصَرٍ عَاتِيَةِ سَخَّرَهَا عَلَيْهِمْ سبع ليال وثمانية أيام حسوما فترى القوم فيها صرعا كأنهم أعجاز نخل خاوية.
All these ayats which I've recited, it talks about the previous nations, what happened to them before us, what happened to Aad, what happened to Thamud. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks her question, فَهَلْ تَرَى لَهُمْ مِنْ بَاقِيَا. Do you see any remains of them today in the world? Are they present today? Are they alive today? And then Allah says, وَجَاءَ فِرْعَوْنَ. Then Fir'aun came.
وَالْمُؤْتَفِكَاتُ بِالْخَاطِئَةِ فَعَسَوْ رَسُولَ رَبِّهِمْ فَأَخَذَهُمْ أَخْذَةَ الرَّابِيَةِ إِنَّا لَمَّا طَغَى الْمَاءُ حَمَلْنَاكُمْ فِي الْجَارِيَةِ لِنَجْعَلَهَا لَكُمْ تَذْكِرَةً وَتَعِيَهَا أُذُنُ وَاعِيَةِ.
All these ayats, Allah SWT is trying to talk the preface. These are the foreword, not the reality. Not the reality. This is not the haqiqat. It's coming up. Now this is the reality. فَإِذَا نُفِخَ فِي السُّورِ. When Israfil alayhi salam will blow the trumpet, he will blow the sur. What will happen? نَفْخَةٌ وَاحِدَةٌ. It will happen one time. Allah, then what will happen?
فَيَوْمَئِذٍ وَقَعَتِ الْوَاقِعَةِ.
Then the reality will occur, the real reality. Allah, what will happen on that day?
وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءِ.
Allah is saying the sky will be into pieces. It will break into pieces.
وَانْشَقَّتِ السَّمَاءُ فَهِيَ يَوْمَئِذٍ وَاهِيَةٌ وَالْمَلَكُ عَلَىٰ أَرْجَائِهَا.
You will see angels will be coming down from the sky.
وَيَحْمِلُ عَرْشَ رَبِّكَ فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ ثَمَانِيَةٌ.
Eight angels will be holding the arsh of Allah, the throne of Allah. It will come down.
وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمٍ.
Jahannam, Allah will bring Jahannam.
وَأُزْلِفَتُ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ.
Allah will bring Jannah.
وَوَضَعَ الْمَوَاضِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ.
Allah will bring the weighing scale, the weighing machine. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not weigh the quantity, my brothers and elders.
Allah will weigh the quality. The quality.
أَحْسَنُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ. I have created death and life.
لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ.
I want to test you. This life is a test.
أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا.
Which one of you does quality of actions? Quality. Quality. Allah doesn't want quantity. Allah wants a heart which fears from Allah. Allah wants quality. He needs ikhlas, sincerity. My brothers and elders, that day, يَوْمَ إِذٍ تُعْرَضُونَ. Allah will bring each one of us. We will be presented to Allah. لَا تَخْفَى مِنْكُمْ خَافِيَةً. We cannot hide on that day.
أَيْنَ الْمَفَرْ.
Is there any place to escape? You cannot go away. Brothers and elders, we can run in dunya, we can escape in dunya, we can hide in this world, but we cannot hide on that day.
كَلَّا لَا وَزَرْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ يَوْمَئِذٍ الْمُسْتَقَرْ يُنَبَّأُ الْإِنسَانِ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِمَا قَدَّمَ وَأَخَّرْ.
Allah will tell you what you were doing in Columbus in the morning, when no one was looking at you. Your mother and dad were sleeping in their rooms, and you were alone. No one was with you. Not your wife, not your children, not your siblings, not your roommates, not your co-workers. No one. You were alone. What you were doing?
يُنَبَّأُ الْإِنسَانِ.
I will tell this human being. بِمَا قَدَّمَ وَأَخَّرْ. What he has done. You know, what he has sent. What he has done. You know, in the upfront, or what he has done in the past, what he has done in the present, what he has done in the future. My brothers and elders,
فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِ.
The person who gets the book of deeds in his right hand. Now what he does, he screams,
هَاُمْ هَاُمْ.
So brothers, you know, they come to him, brother, what's wrong with you? Why are you screaming? He say,
اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِيَ.
Read my book, I passed my exam. I passed my exam. This is not exam of a university of Ohio. This is not the exam of this world. No, my brothers and elders, this is the exam of your whole life.
He will say, اِقْرَأُوا كِتَابِ.
Read my book, I passed my exam. He said, how did you pass? What were you doing? What were you doing? You were living with me in Columbus. What extra things you were doing? He will say,
إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَا.
Indeed, I had complete yaqeen and belief and conviction that I will meet with my reckoning. Mulaqin hisabiya. I will meet with my hisab and kitab. I have to leave this world. My brothers and elders, this life is temporary. I came from Atlanta, Georgia, to give Jumma Khutbah here. I'm not here permanently. I'm flying out tomorrow morning. My brothers and elders, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. We all are inhabitants of Jannah. Adam alayhi salam came from Jannah. We have to go in Jannah. We are in transit right now. We're in transit. The real life is the life hereafter. This world, this life, my brothers and sisters, it's a deception. It's a deception. The ayats which I've recited, wasari'u, run, ila maghfiratin min rabbikum, towards the forgiveness of your Rabb, wa jannatin, run towards Jannah, towards paradise. Allah, what kind of paradise? Arduha samawatu wal ard, the width of this paradise is more than the heavens and the skies. U'iddat lil muttaqeen. This paradise has been created for the people who fear from Allah, who are muttaqeen. Allah, who are they? Alladhina yunfiquna fis sarra. The muttaqeen are the ones who spend in the path of Allah, who spend fis sarra wad darra. When they are poor, when they are rich, when they are in ease, and when they are not in ease, they spend in the path of Allah. And my brothers and elders, the second quality of a believer is not regarding wealth, is not regarding salat, is not regarding sadaqah, is not regarding hajj, is not regarding zakat, is not regarding any ibadat, but it is regarding ikhlaq. It is regarding ikhlaq. What is the second quality? Walkadhimina al-ghayz. Muttaqeen are the people who drink their anger. Who drink their anger. My brothers and elders and my sisters who are listening, we need to see and visualize in our life that are we angry? Do we drink our anger or not? وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْظِ. They drink their anger. One thing that you don't get angry. You know, if you don't want angry, then you need to see the doctor if something is wrong with you. My brothers and elders, if you are getting angry, but you need to stop your anger, control your anger. This is the quality of a believer. And the third quality, وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. The people who forgive humanity. Who forgive humanity. Forgive humanity. My brothers and elders, this sifat, this quality of forgiveness, we are deprived of this sifat. We are deprived of this quality. My brothers and elders, there is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, closest to the meaning, that one person, there are four people who will not be forgiven even in Laylatul Qadr. Four people will not be forgiven even in Laylatul Qadr. Who are they? First, person who drinks alcohol and sharab, who's addicted to alcohol and sharab, doesn't leave alcohol, sharab, he will not be forgiven even in Laylatul Qadr. Second person who is disobedient to his parents, who's a disobedient to his parents and his parents are not pleased with him, he will not be forgiven in Laylatul Qadr. Third person, qati' ar-rahm, the person who breaks the ties in relationships with people, with his family members, with uncle and aunt, with brother and sister. I met one brother, I'm like, brother, why don't you call your sister or your uncle or your aunt? He says, they don't call me, why should I call them? They don't care about me, why should I care about them? No, my brothers and elders, Rasulullah, he taught us ikhlaq. He said, O Ali, should I tell you the ikhlaq of awwaleen and akhireen? He said, ajal ya Rasulullah, ma huwa ya Rasulullah? He said, four things. Tassil man qata'ak. O Ali, the one who breaks with you join with him. The one who breaks ties with you, doesn't want to see your face, you call him on Eid. You call him, say, brother, I forgive you. Sister, I forgive you. My uncle, I forgive you. My aunt, I forgive you. You know that they are the culprit. You know that they have done wrong with you. But still, tassil man qata'ak. You need to join the relations. The one who breaks with you. Tu'ti amman haramak. The person who deprives you, you give him his right. Wa'afu amman zalamak. You forgive the people who has done oppression on you. Forgive them. Forgive them. Forgive them. Ahsin man asa'a ilayk. The person who does bad with you, you do good with him. You do good with him. My brothers and elders, that fourth person who will not be forgiven in Laylatul Qadr is Mushahin, the one who has grudge, stinginess, bad feeling. hasad, kina, bughd. You know, he has stinginess, grudge, all these bad things, bad feelings for the other Muslim, for the other human being. He will not be forgiven even in Laylatul Qadr. So my brothers and elders, I came from very far. The sisters who are listening, the brothers who are listening, I want to request few things regarding ikhlaq. First thing, we need to control our anger. We need to control our anger. I need to ask my wife, how is my ikhlaq? She will tell me, how is my ikhlaq? The wife need to ask the husband, you know, that how is the ikhlaq of the wife? My brothers and elders, the second thing is to forgive humanity. Clean our heart, my brothers and elders. Clean our heart. We have small things. We are not talking to people. We are not talking to our blood relations, our brother, our sister, our neighbor, our roommate, our co-worker. We don't speak to him. Why? Because he doesn't like me. He doesn't want to see my face. Oh, you know, he has done wrong to me. Oh, my uncle never invited me in his daughter's wedding. I will not talk to him. No, brothers and elders, these are all lame things. We need to clean our heart. Clean our heart. Like we clean the house on Friday, like we clean our hard disk, like we format the phone. We clean everything. We need to clean our heart on daily basis. Daily basis, we need to clean our heart. And my brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know the ayats which I've recited, I will make the translation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْكَاذِمِينَ الْغَيْذِ. The people who drink their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. The people who forgive humanity. وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. Allah loves the people, you know, who do ihsan. And then, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. The person, a muttaqi person, when he does an immodest, a shameless act, or he does dhulm, oppression on himself or herself, what does he do? ذَكَرُ اللَّهِ. He remembers Allah right away. فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. He forgives, he asks forgiveness from Allah immediately. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Is there anyone else who will forgive the sins of this person other than Allah? وَلَمْ يُسِرُّوا. He does not insist on that sin. عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا. Whatever he has done. وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. And he knows. And then my brothers and elders, Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ. For them, جَزَاؤُهُمْ. For them, there is reward. For these people, there is reward. جَنَّاتٌ تَجْرِي. A paradise. تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. You will see rivers will be flowing underneath them. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. They will live there forever. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. And this is the reward for the people who do actions. My brothers and elders, we always say this. Actions speak louder than words. Even I say a lot of good things on the member, you don't act upon it, doesn't matter. It will be only talks. Actions speak louder than words. This is Quran. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. This is the reward for the people who do good actions. عَامِلِينَ, the person who does amal, action. My brothers and elders. And then the second, in the next ayah, Allah says, هَذَا بَيَانُ لِلنَّاسِ. This Quran, this is a bayan. This is a talk for human beings. People think these are normal talks. But Allah is saying, وَمَوْعِذَا. This is nasihat. This is an advice. لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. For the people who fear from Allah. This is an advice. This is a way of life. This is how you should spend your life. My brothers and elders, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to the Sahaba, what is the action which is the highest in the eyes of Allah? The action which is the highest in the eyes of Allah. Sahaba replied, As-salah, praying 5 times. He said, La. Ahsantu, very good, but that's not what I'm asking. Something else. He said, Az-zakat, you know, Sawm Ramadan, Al-Hajj fi Baytullah. In all the good actions, Rasulullah s.a.w. replied, very good, but that's not what I'm asking. At the end, Sahaba said, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and His Messenger, they better know. What is the action? What is the action which is the highest in the eyes of Allah? So Rasulullah s.a.w. replied, the action which is the highest in the eyes of Allah is to love each other for the sake of Allah. Al-hubbu lillah. Al-hubbu lillah. Love each other for the sake of Allah. For the sake of Allah. My brothers and elders, we need to revive these sunnahs. And my brothers and elders, one sahabi, his name is Ma'ad ibn Jabal. Every khutbah, wherever I travel, I give khutbahs everywhere in the US. Wherever I travel, I narrate this hadith at the end. And this is very important hadith. The brothers and sisters who are sleeping or they are drowsy, please wake up and listen. This is the last thing. Inshallah, we have the second khutbah and pray. My brothers and sisters, Ma'ad ibn Jabal. Rasulullah said to Ma'ad ibn Jabal, "Oh Ma'ad, oh Ma'ad, should I tell you the khulasa of deen? The summary of deen? The conclusion of deen?" He said, "Ajal ya Rasulullah, ma huwa ya Rasulullah?" My brothers and elders, Rasulullah did not say a word. He took out his tongue and he grabbed his tongue from his two fingertips like this. He said, "Oh Ma'ad, kuffa hadha. Safeguard your tongue. This is khulasa of deen. This is summary of deen. This is conclusion of your religion, of your deen, Islam." He said, "Ya Rasulullah, we will go in Jahannam, we'll be burned in the hellfire because of misusing our lisan, our tongue." Thaqilat ki ummika ya ibn Jabal. Oh son of Jabal, the majority of Jahannamis, the majority of the people will be burned in the hellfire because of misusing their lisan, their tongue. I will repeat this again. Rasulullah said to Ma'az, "Oh Ma'az, kuffa hadha, safeguard your tongue." He said, "Ya Rasulullah, we'll go in Jahannam because of misusing our lisan, our tongue." He said, majority of the people, they will be burned in the hellfire because of misusing their tongue, their lisan. So my brothers and elders, I came from very far. I flew from Atlanta in the morning. I request all the brothers and sisters that we make tawbah. We ask forgiveness from Allah. That, "Ya Allah, whatever I have done till now, I make tawbah. I seek refuge. I seek forgiveness." And my brothers and elders, we control our tongue. Every sin is related to tongue. Control our tongue. Don't talk bad about anyone. We never know that he will die on iman and I will die on kufr. We never know this. So we don't talk bad. Don't lie, don't cheat, don't fraud, don't do backbiting, ghiba. Don't do this. Control it. Abu Bakr Siddiq used to put stones in his mouth so he does not speak anything wrong. Anything wrong. May Allah give us tawfiq, my brothers and elders, to convey to the whole of humanity and to implement these talks in our life and to convey to the whole of humanity. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wa salamun ala al mursaleen. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الحمد لله الذي استعينه واستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسولي رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذوهم غرضا من بعدي فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبو بكر في الجنة عمر في الجنة عثمان في الجنة علي في الجنة طلحة في الجنة Zubair fil Jannah, Abdul Rahman bin Auf fil Jannah, Sa'ad bin Abi Waqas fil Jannah, Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah fil Jannah, Sa'id fil Jannah, La ilaha illallah al Halim al Kareem, Subhanallah Rabbil Arsh al Azim, Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Nas'aluka mawjibat rahmatik, Wa azaim maghfiratik, Wal ghanimata min kulli bir, Wal salamata min kulli ithm, La tada'lana dhanban illa ghafarta, ولا هما إلا فرجتا ولا دينا إلا قضيتا ولا مريضا إلا شفيتا ولا ميتا إلا رحمتا ولا كربا إلا نفستا ولا ضالا إلا هديتا ولا مبتلا إلا عافيتا ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا قضيتها ويسرتها يا أرحم الراحمين يا أول الأولين يا آخر الآخرين يا ذي القوة المتين يا راحم المساكين اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه نبيك وعبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذ منه نبيك وعبدك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وأنت المستعان وأنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الشرك والمشركين ودم أعداء الدين اللهم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين وجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا اللهم اغفر لنا للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم أموات اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب الحشر وقنا عذاب الميزان اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وعملا متقبلا اللهم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب القبر ونعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم ونعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال ونعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال ونعوذ بك من فتنة المسيح الدجال ونعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات ونعوذ بك من فتنة المأثم والمغرم اللهم ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان أن آمنوا بربكم فآمنا ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار وتوفنا مع الأبرار وتوفنا مع الأبرار اللهم ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا اللهم من أحييته منا فأحيي على الإسلام وَمَنْ تَوَفَّيْتَهُ مِنَّا فَتَوَفَّهُ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ وَمَنْ تَوَفَّيْتَهُ مِنَّا فَتَوَفَّهُ عَلَى الْإِيمَانِ اللهم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تكفرون أقم الصلاة. Please make the line straight, inshallah. Fill in the first row, second row, third row. Fill in the gaps. Please turn off your cell phones, brothers and elders. Please turn off your cell phones. Put it on silent mode. Everyone, please check your cell phone. We don't want any cell phone to ring in the salat. Inshallah, put your heels on the line so the row can become straight, inshallah. And fill in the gaps, please. Jazakumullah khair.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
لا إله إلا الله استوى عتدل ترسو. Please make the line straight, inshallah. Fill in the gaps, please. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر سمي الله لمن حمده الله
Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
Allahumma barik lahum wa 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 barik lahum w